This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We welcome you to worship, even in this new way. We thank you that you are with us, even virtually, during these uncertain and curious times. I'm so grateful to be a part of this church with you. We are able to record worship in this way this week. We're not sure what's going to be possible next week with new restrictions and so forth. But I pray that you would check your emails each Sunday morning when you will receive some notification about a worship opportunity which comes into your email inbox on Sunday mornings at 10 a.m. Please also notice that there will be a prayer time on Wednesday evenings, a conference call, where we will share prayers of the people. And at that time, we will be together in prayer over the telephone at 7 p.m. each Wednesday. The directions for all of this are on our church website, and we pray that you would visit that website as well, anaheimumc.org. Now let us lift our hearts in praise together, even though we may be farther apart than usual. Let us worship the God in whom we believe. Amen.
Child of grace. Our scripture reading is from John, the third chapter, 1 through 8 and 14 through 17. Now there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus by night and said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these things that you do apart from the presence of God." Jesus answered him, "Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above." Nicodemus said to him, "How can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of the water and the Spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh. What is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have life eternal. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Oh.
During my high school years, I was able to go to a concert by a band named REM, and they sang a song called "This Is the End of the World as We Know It, and I Feel Fine." It's difficult to feel fine when the end of the world as we know it is upon us, when everything is changing, when suddenly we have to live in an entirely different way. This is our reality. And yet we come together and we adapt. And it's good to be with you in worship in this way. Of course, this is not the first time that people have experienced dramatic changes where everything that they knew began to change. In our scripture today, we see that the Pharisee Nicodemus comes to Jesus by night. Perhaps he wanted to hide the fact that he had questions for Jesus. But he realized that Jesus was going to change everything. All of the rules and laws that Nicodemus had understood and had memorized and studied over the years, all of those details of the faith seemed to be changing, because here was this teacher calling him and many others simply to have a relationship with God and with him, Jesus of Nazareth. Suddenly, everything was changing. So he came by night, in the dark of night, to ask Jesus questions. And as he did this, Jesus seemed to make things even more uncertain for Nicodemus. He said, "You must be born from above." In John chapter 3, verse 8, he continues, "The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes." It's as though Jesus is reminding Nicodemus, teaching him that things are going to become more disorienting before they ever become certain again. You have to follow the wind, follow the Spirit, wherever the Spirit may lead. Even if the world seems to be coming to an end, the world as you know it, keep your eyes open. Understand how God might still be at work. What have we to learn through this process? I've been talking with some of our worship leaders and leaders of our church about the things that we're already learning during this time, because we're keeping our eyes open to the lessons that God would teach us. For example, on Wednesday of this past week, we did gather over the phone, and over 20-some people gathered in this phone call. We'd never tried this before as a church, but we began to adapt. We had a wonderful sacred prayer time over the phone. And here we are in worship together on a Sunday morning in a new way. These are surely skills that our church will need to learn in order to reach out to a new generation, to reach out to many people over the internet, perhaps to thousands and more people of our neighbors who are isolated at home, who dearly need to hear words of God's love and grace. These are the things we will learn if we have eyes to see and ears to hear what the Spirit would teach us, wherever the Spirit's winds might be blowing, in entirely new ways. It happened, of course, to the Israelites that in 586 BC, everything changed as they knew it. The Babylonians came to destroy their temple. 586 years before Jesus' birth, these outsiders came and destroyed everything that they knew. They were devastated, and much of the Bible, much of the Old Testament of our scriptures was written during those times when people were trying to salvage what was true, salvage some remnant of their faith and tradition. They also created forms of worship during that time that were entirely different. They could no longer worship in the temple and sacrifice animals to their God. They had to worship wherever they were. So they began to gather around the Word, and they would sit with a rabbi who would teach them about their tradition, their stories, their scriptures. And this practice, 586 years before Jesus' birth, influences our tradition today. It brings me to sit here with the Bible and talk with you, even over the internet this morning. Because they adapted, because they did not give up their faith in God, they saw a new way to worship, and their faith endured and influences the way that we worship still today. We know that it's possible to see God in these changes if we will keep our eyes open to see, our ears open to hear, our hearts open to the neighbors who need us. I've been so inspired by our provisions team in our church and our missions and outreach because they continue to find creative ways to serve our neighbors even during this time. An email has gone out to the entire congregation saying if there's anyone in need of food, anyone in need of anything at all, to let the provisions team know so that we can bring cooked meals or any other necessity. If somebody must go to the shopping, to go shopping for basic necessities but doesn't feel safe in doing so because they're a senior, the provisions team is ready and willing to run to the Walgreens or wherever we need to go to provide for those needs. Perhaps this experience may bring us closer together in the end, and we will even gain the fruit of new understanding of worship with a broader spectrum of neighbors. Let us keep our eyes open and our ears open and remember that the wind blows where it chooses. We hear the sound of it, but we do not know where it comes from or where it goes. Let us be willing to follow God's Spirit wherever that Spirit would lead. Then perhaps in the end, we may be able to sing a song like this. This is the end of the world as we know it, and I do feel fine. Because we all know and believe that we are in God's hands. May it be so. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace in every circumstance, now and forevermore. Amen.